It may be more than 6,500 kilometres away, but at a new Tate Britain exhibition, black artists are telling the story of how Central Caribbean art has been to the UK.
This isn't an art that's in a cul-de-sac somewhere in a different part of the world. It shows how Britain itself still is a home to some of the most innovative and progressive art that you could think about. It's only Britain that can do that, and it's only the fusion of this relationship between the Caribbean and Britain that can do that as well.
They've come to seek work in Britain and are ready and willing to do any kind of job that will help the motherland along the road to prosperity.
That relationship can be partially traced back to the influx of Caribbean immigrants to post-war Britain, known as the Windrush Generation. The name comes from the MV Empire Windrush ship, which first docked in Essex in 1948, bringing workers from Jamaica, Trinidad and Tobago, and other islands. While the exhibit shows how British and Caribbean identities align, it does not shy away from addressing discrimination against black Britons. The series of photographs, Go West, Young Man, by Keith Piper, represents the abuse of the black male body, from slavery to migration. And Eddie Chambers' destruction of the National Front reimagines the Union Jack flag, which had been hijacked by far-right groups.
I think even before you come into this exhibition, you know it's an important one to recognise the contribution of black people and black artists specifically to British society, especially at a time where we're talking about it in the wake of the Black Lives Matter movement and also rising anti-immigrant sentiment in Britain with Brexit and so on.
The future of this relationship is important here too.
That last section is called Past, Present, Future. And so although we don't know the form work will take in future, nevertheless, work artists from the present are making work around how the past relates to the present and the future.
While the story of black British art is evolving, art lovers can visit until April to appreciate how far it's come and how it became a crucial part of Britain's national story. Adama Munu, TRT World.